bursts of joy. People grateful to be alive.
Hello, how are you?
A few hours earlier, in the central Mediterranean Sea,
which language do you speak? English?
Their boat was about to sink.
Il y a des personnes francophones?
In spite of the very bad weather, their small rubber boat took to sea at around midnight, not far from Tripoli. The teams on board the Bourbon Argos came to the refugees' rescue, 121 people in all, including 28 women and 6 children.
They're wet from the rain and they're in a very distressed situation, a lot of scared people. But now it's good to have them on deck, they're all safe. We're trying to give them a dignified reception here.
After Dignity 1 was deployed off the Libyan coast a month ago, the Bourbon Argos 2 resumed its search and rescue operations with a team of doctors, nurses and logistics experts on board. Later that evening, the refugees landed on the Italian coast. A third MSF team is on the Aquarius, again ready to provide assistance off the northern coast of Libya.
Many people die at sea, and this is the responsibility of the European community to offer them a safe and legal passage instead of this dangerous and useless journey.
Since the 20th of March, migrants arriving clandestinely on the Greek islands are automatically sent back to Turkey.
This is an unacceptable policy and an attack on the values of the European Union. We need a fast-track system, probably with humanitarian visas, to let the refugees in. They must be allowed to choose their final destination. It's not by preventing them or closing a border that they're going to stop people coming to Europe.
2 months after the signing of the deal by Brussels and Ankara, the chaos continues in Greece. 12,000 migrants and refugees have been living, or rather surviving, in this camp in Idomeni since Macedonia closed its borders.
Conditions in the camp are really bad, as you can see. There are germs everywhere because there aren't enough toilets available. So children just get up and go to the toilet outside. And there are a lot of insects too. They bite the kids and it increases the risk of them getting sick. The situation is really bad.
Given the scale of the health emergency, MSF has this month launched a vaccination campaign.
Bravo!
In 3 days, over 3,000 children were vaccinated against 10 diseases such as diphtheria, hepatitis B, polio and pneumonia.
Good boy.
Being put in this very vulnerable position, they're now exposed to quite a number of disease and illness, and entirely unnecessary, and this really needs to change.
50,000 migrants and refugees are still stranded in Greece. Some are in transit camps. Others are locked up in hotspots far beyond the maximum limit established for administrative detention.
Where is the human rights? This is not camp, this is prison.
MSF has appealed to the Greek authorities and European Union to open immediately the gates at these hotspots.